Well, here we are, folks. It is the 10th of September, 2015. Some of you listening, it is already early morning in the 11th of September. But we are on day 24, take 5 for you. Are you ready to spend some time with the Lord? How did your supplements go yesterday? Were you taking your vitamins? Were you building up your strength as you work out and walk out your own salvation? Taking in the ingredients? Taking in the ingredients of what God wants to give you. Well, we talked about some ingredients yesterday, how we can build up our strength. We need to do that. It's like we exercise. We exercise our bodies. We've also got to exercise our spiritual man. That's how we get stronger and can move forward in the things that God would have us to do. We're going to spend a little bit of time looking at a couple of different attitudes that we want to develop. But God wants us to know of His goodness. Of His goodness that He has for us. For each one of us. When we look at this, I want you to get an idea. There's the story of the rich young ruler who came up to Jesus and he wanted to become a follower. And he began a dialogue with Jesus. And Jesus said, "No one is good but one, that is God." You can read that in Mark 10, verses 17 and 18. "For the Son of God was referring to me." Now, this is an interesting conversation. I want you to understand and grab a hold of this. Who this me is. "I am the Spirit of goodness." I am the Spirit of goodness. Now, let's take a little transition now into a very famous psalm that many people can quote. I've seen videos of small children quote this psalm, Psalm 23. Quite often, it has been used over many, many years at funerals. But you see, this is a living psalm of David. A psalm dedicated to our shepherd. And if we're a sheep and we have a shepherd, that is a living relationship. So I want you to use this a part of your declaration today. I want you to use this as a part of your declaration as you would read Psalm 23, read it, and say it and proclaim it as being yours. Now here it is. I'm going to be speaking in your voice again. "The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want." Wow, just right there. Grab a hold of what you just declared. The Lord God is my shepherd. A shepherd takes care of his sheep. I shall not want, or I shall not lack. And this is what your shepherd does for you. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. In other words, he takes me to the good places. The Lord is my shepherd, and he takes me to the good places. the green pastures, the still waters. You know, sheep, they won't drink out of water that has a lot of rushing to it. They'll go to the pools where it's nice and calm. And you know what? That's kind of like us. We don't like to go and have to drink out of stuff or to be filled up where everything is just kind of rushing by. We can't get that savor of just relaxation. I know when I come back from a walk, I'm sweaty and I'm hot and I'm dripping. And so I'll go, even though it's hot outside, I'll go in my backyard. And we have a table out there and chairs and an umbrella. And I'll get a bottle of cold water and I'll just sit out there and relax and drink in that cool water. And then in verse 3, it says, He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. God is doing this for you and me. He restores my soul. You know, sometimes we can get awful soulish. In other words, in our own humanity, we're not walking spiritually. We're not being connected by our spirit to God. We're walking in our own fleshly, soulish ways. But you see, God wants to restore that. He wants to bring us back. He wants to bring us back, and He does that. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake. In other words, for God's name's sake, He's going to lead you to the place that you need to be. The place that He wants you to be. Just think of it. The name Christian simply means this: little Christ. Little Christ. And as a little Christ, with the power of the Holy Spirit, in the authority that has been given to us by Jesus, we can do the things that He did, and even greater things. That's His own words that He spoke to His early disciples. And you can read in the book of John, I believe around chapter 13 or 14. But you see, as we go on, we're going to go through some tough times. In verse 4, it says, Yes, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. In Israel, someplace outside of Jerusalem, there actually is a valley called the Shadow of Death. We have a valley here in America we call Death Valley. We don't name places like that if there is not some connotation or some connection to probably some deadly acts or death. I know in Death Valley here in the United States, there's a place called, I believe it's called Dead Water. In other words, there was a type of water that if you drank it, you would probably die. Or they saw animals that have drunk of the water. They drank the water and they would see their bones laying around. But you see, in the earlier verse, it says, God takes us and leads us by the still waters, the good waters, where He wants us to be. So you can declare that I will fear no evil. You have the power and authority. You're covered by the blood of Jesus. You can call holy angels to come about and around you. So if you go through those tough days, those tough times, you have nothing to fear but fear itself. And that's something that Satan likes to bring upon you. And you can cast that down by your own declarations. Very simple. I will fear no evil. In the name of Jesus, I will fear no evil. Now, this is something special that God does for us. And it really highlights the title of this message, A Good Spread. Now, listen to this. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. I love this. I looked this up. And what this simply means is it's like God has prepared a picnic. He has laid out all of the good stuff before you to sit down, put on a napkin, just sit and relax, and God has given you all of His best. And He's going to set it in front of your enemies. They're going to look, and you're going to be, I'll just say, picnicking with God. Like they like to say in Trinidad, I'm going to go lime with God. The idea of lime or liming is just go and be in the presence and chat and relax. Get this in your mind. It's like God is taking you out. You're out in the green pastures. You're by the still waters. You got some people looking around at what's going on. And Jesus comes along beside you. And He's carrying a picnic basket. And He lays out everything right there in that green pasture. And the enemy's looking around. And they're just going, I can't believe my eyes. And you can just simply say, I will fear no evil. It also goes on, says, you anoint my head with oil, and my cup runs over. Not only does He feed you and make a great spread, a good spread, but He gives you a freshness, anoints you with oil, covers you with oil. I get this. He gives you a massage, an oil massage. The anointing, it means a rubbing on. Can you imagine just being out on a picnic and sitting with Jesus? It's a nice, beautiful day. And Jesus sits there beside you as your shepherd, as your friend. And says, I think I'm going to put some oil on you. Give you a little massage. Make you relax. Keep going. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow you. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of our lives. I love this word, and I've been putting it out over and over again as we see on the news around us, Black Lives Matter, White Lives Matter, Police Lives Matter. Babies' lives matter. Whales' lives matter. I saw one the other day that chickens' lives matter. Well, you know the basis of all of it? God says all lives matter to me because I am the creator of all life. So look at this. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow you, shall follow me all the days of our lives, because God says all lives matter. And I will dwell, and you will dwell, and we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.